Hey guys, as you can see, this is not a Zoom call. Well, I'm gonna be honest with you. That is because I realized that I forgot to record the class for the first two tricks. So for the first two tricks, it's just gonna be me talking to my phone. And then for the remaining four tricks, it's gonna be the Zoom call. So at the end, you'll be getting all of the tricks of me teaching that I had planned for this workshop. It's just gonna be a little different and not what I planned it to be, but that's totally okay. I just wanted to start off with this workshop by saying that although this class is totally free, it's my gift to you. I wanted to give you the option to donate if you wanted to. I am currently trying to give my all to my classes and to my students. Because of that, I've bought studio lights to make sure I have a nice, well-lit teaching space. And I've also invested in a really nice webcam to ensure that you guys have the clearest image possible of me while I'm teaching. My next big investment that I would like to make is a really nice DSLR camera so that I can record really clear quality tutorials for you. So like I said, if you're interested into donating to me to help me make my best teaching environment that I can for you, my PayPal and my Venmo will be linked in the description, but obviously feel no pressure at all to do that. This is my gift to you guys. So getting right into the tricks, I am going to be teaching my tricks with two hula hoops. The first one is going to be a 28-inch 5/8 polypro hula hoop, and the second hula hoop I'm going to be teaching with is a 30-inch hula hoop. I recommend that you just use whatever hoop you feel the most comfortable with, but I will say that if you are using a hoop that is over like 33 inches, some of the more techie tricks will be a little bit harder to accomplish. Also, if you have low ceilings, a larger hula hoop will hit your ceilings for at least one of this trick. So make sure you keep that in mind when practicing as well. So getting right into the first two workshops I taught, or first two tricks I taught in this workshop. The first one was this really cool linear ghosting isolation to hand spin to unicorn flip combo. And this is what it looked like. Ta-da! Okay, so this trick starts with a ghosting isolation, a vertical ghosting isolation. If you don't know how to do a vertical ghosting isolation, it's actually super easy. This is how you do it. You're going to take a hand, any hand. This is my right hand, and it is going to be holding the hula hoop. Your other hand is going to be the ghosting hand. Okay, and it is not going to be really holding the hula hoop at all. It's going to be tracing the hula hoop, okay? So forgetting about the ghosting hand for just 1 second, we're gonna concentrate solely on our holding hand. The hoop is going to start by, or the trick is going to start with you holding your hoop down at your waist with your hand on 12 o'clock. Make sure your fingers are curled in towards your face. So you don't wanna be gripping the hoop like this. Instead, you want to grip the hoop like these. From here, you are going to bring your hoop to your chest as you shoot your arm out to the right. And then from here, you're going to raise the hoop above your head as you bring the bring your hand down to 6 o'clock on the hula hoop. So all together, it looks like this. Okay. Bringing in your ghosting hand here, you are going to take it and wrap it around the hula hoop. But I want you to notice that you're going to leave a little bit of space in between your hand and the hula hoop. So your hand isn't quite gripping the hoop. It's just basically holding the hula hoop in a little space compared to our other hand. Now that baby is actually gripping the hula hoop, right? So it's the same thing. You are going to bring your hula hoop up to your chest, both elbows pointed out, and raise the hula hoop above your head. Fingertips are facing towards your face. Okay, this is a nice and smooth, linear, ghosting isolation upward. Okay, from here, you are going to drop a hand and do a hand spin. Okay, again. You're gonna drop a hand. I'm dropping my left hand because I feel more comfortable doing my hand spins on my right hand. And you're going to do a hand spin. You want to make sure that you are ending your hand spin with your fingers pointed away from your face, okay? So you don't want this, all right? You want this, okay? Perfect. So let's try what we've learned all together. Starting at our hands on 12 o'clock. 3, 2, 1, push the hoop up. Hand spin. Make sure your grip has your fingers pointed away from your face. Okay, from here we are going to lower our hoop down onto our head and go into a unicorn coin flip. Okay, so how I like to teach this trick is I want you to go ahead and take your hoop and put it on the flattest part of your head. So for me, that's my hairline. For some reason, that's just the flattest part of my head, okay? And that's where I'm going to aim the bottom of the hoop. And from here, I'm going to use just the tippy tips of my fingers, and I'm going to push my hula hoop backwards with all the with just some strength in my right hand. So I'm not pushing or anything with my left hand. This hand is used to balance, while my other hand is used to push the hula hoop back. Just like that. It's super important to make sure you are doing this trick on the flattest part of your forehead, and you are pushing just a little bit, just enough to give it a little bit of a rotation. Okay, let's go ahead and practice our unicorn coin flips together 3 times before we move on. 3, 2, 1, coin flip. 3, 2, 1, coin flip. 3, 2, 1, coin flip. Okay, awesome. So now that we've talked about how to get up to the unicorn coin flip, I'm gonna go ahead right now and teach you how to do an advanced variation of this trick that involves a turn. So if you guys watch my flow videos, you know that I love to come up with ways to spin around in a circle. So that is what I'm going to teach you how to do right now. So right now, this is how we've learned the trick. Isolation up, hand spin, forehead, coin flip. If you are feeling comfortable with that and you would like to incorporate the turn, this is what it looks like. Okay, so how I achieve that is that as I'm ghosting the hula hoop up above my head, I'm going to be turning over my right shoulder. I'm going to be doing a complete 360 turn back towards the front, and it'll look like this. Okay, one more time. And then once I get back to the front again, that's when I start my hand spin and then lower the hoop onto my forehead to do a coin flip. So let's go ahead and practice what we've learned so far. If you are feeling comfortable with incorporating the turn, let's go ahead and do that. If you're not, don't sweat it. I'll meet you where you're at, okay? So we're gonna practice it 3 times. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Again, isolate up, hand spin to your head, coin flip. Last time. Now, the final part of this trick is how do we catch it in a wedgie, okay? This is what it looks like. If you are unfamiliar with how to catch things into a wedgie, I'm going to break that down right here, right now for you. Essentially, what we are doing is after we coin flip it, the hula hoop is going to fall off of our heads eventually because gravity, right, okay? So when it falls off of our head, what we are going to do is take our hand and stick it through the hoop like we are giving the hoop gods in the sky a high five, okay? And then from here, we are going to take our opposite side leg. So for me, wiggle, wiggle, that's my left leg, and I'm putting it through the hoop. So I got my opposite side legs in the hoop. From here, I'm going to take my furry hand, that would be my left hand, and I'm going to push it through the hoop and up and over my head. The hoop should fall, and now we are in a wedgie. Okay, again, coin flip, stick our hands through the hoop, like we're giving the hoop gods in the sky a high five. From here, opposite side leg, okay, free hand through the hoop, push our hoops up and over our head, and then we will be in a wedgie. Practice this entrance slow at first. Make sure you're doing all the steps. And with practice, you will be able to do it faster. Okay. So let's go ahead and practice the entire trick three times together, and we will move on to the second trick that I forgot to record. And then after that, it will be all footage from the workshop. Three, two, one, go. Again, three, two, one, go. Last time, three, two, one, go. All right, so that's how you do the trick. The second trick that I am going to be teaching is how to do this really cool escalator catch into a neck hooping combo. This is what it looks like. I'm going to switch to my green hoop for this one just because I feel like it shows up better compared to my blue. And this is what the trick looks like. Okay, so for starters, we are going to start off with this hoop in our dominant hand. For me, that's my right hand. And from here, I'm going to fold it inward, okay? So you want to make sure that this big, beautiful gap right here is behind your body, okay? You don't want this. If you have this, that means that you folded the hoop the wrong way, okay? So we're folding it back. And our arm is out to our side. From here, we are going to move the hula hoop up at a diagonal, so our hand is above our head on the right-hand side. And from here, we are going to push our hula hoop forward one whole time, okay? So we're here, and we're going to push it down all the way forward. So this time, you should have this big, beautiful gap in front of your face. So all together, let's go ahead and do that a couple of times. Three, two, one, fold back, raise our hand up, fold forward. Again. Three, two, one, fold back, raise our hand up again, fold forward. Okay, so from here we are going to go into an escalator to catching behind our back. This is what it looks like from the back. Folded it back, raised our arm up, folded it forward, catching it behind my back. As you can see, my catching hand has my palm turned outward, and I am grabbing the hula hoop when it's at the center of my back. So my catching hand is just patiently waiting for my hula hoop to land in the center of my back, okay? Now, this can take a little bit of time to get used to, so let's just practice catching the hoop behind our back just a couple of times before we move on. Three, two, one, fold in, up, unwind, catch. Again. Three, two, one, fold in, up, unwind, catch. Last time, three, two, one, fold in, up, unwind, catch. I want you to notice that this is how your hand should look like when you're catching the hula hoop behind your back. From here, we are going to take our thumb and drive it down so the hoop comes up above our heads and out to our sides. This takes a good amount of wrist strength and finger grip strength. So really just make sure you channel all of your strength into your wrist and your fingers to really drive that hand down and push the hula hoop up and over your head and to the right. From here, I want you to continue that motion to your right and rest it on your right shoulder. This is what it should look like. So from the front, this is what it looks like. And one more time from the back, holding the hula hoop back, catch, push it up and over to the right, and then let it rest on my right shoulder. Now, I would like to incorporate an advanced variation real quick before we go on with the rest of the tricks. Just like previously, I showed you how to do that trick by incorporating a turn. Before we go any further, I would like to show you how to do this trick with incorporating a turn. So here's how this trick looks like with the turn. Okay, if you feel comfortable with what we've learned so far, I would like to teach you how to do the turn. So what we're going to do is we are going to take our right foot and cross it over our left and turn over our left shoulder. So we do a full 360 back to the front. Okay, so for getting our hoops, let's just try the turn a couple times. Right leg, cross it over the left. And then turn, 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 back to the front. Now, if we are going to incorporate our hula hoop into this movement, we are going to fold the hula hoop backward as we do the turn, okay? So at the same time your hula hoop folds back and over your arm, you're going to take your right leg and fold it over or cross it over your left, okay? Like this, bam. Now, we are going to turn over our left shoulder, and when we get to the front, we are going to unwind our hula hoop and go into our escalator catch. Okay, so if you'd like to practice that with me, let's try it one time before we move on to the rest of the trick. Take our hula hoop in our right hand, fold it back, cross our leg over, turn when we get to the front, unwind, escalator, catch. Perfect. So now I'm going to move on. When we last left off, before I taught you how to do the turn, our hula hoop was balancing on our right collarbone over our shoulder, and it was on our right-hand side. From here, I want you to pinch the hula hoop with your neck and lean to your left. You'll notice that when you pinch and lean, your hula hoop will naturally swing to the left, which is exactly what we want it to do. I find that if you have some type of clothing right here to prevent rubbing on your actual skin, this trick will be, or this part of the trick will be a lot easier for you. Okay? So after we've pinched and turned to our left, we are going to grip the bottom of the hula hoop with our left hand, and we are going to push the hula hoop up onto our neck for neck hooping. Okay, so again, we just did an escalator down, drove the hoop back and onto our shoulder, then I'm going to pinch and lean, and then push the hoop up onto my neck for neck hooping. Okay, when the hoop is in neck hooping, it should be spinning clockwise, okay? So when we want to get the hoop off of our neck, that means we need to flick our necks down and to the right. Just like that. Okay, so let's go ahead and practice pinching it, getting it onto our necks, and getting the hoop off of our bodies. Let's do that two times. Ready? Go. Pinch, lean, neck hooping, pop it up. Again. Pinch, lean, neck hooping, pop it up. If you are struggling with getting the hoop off of your neck, I really want you to focus diving your chin down to your chest and then flicking your head towards the right and following through with your eyes so you can see where you are throwing the hula hoop. obviously I didn't catch that. But that's the gist of the motion you want to do with your head so that the hula hoop can get off of your neck. Okay, so after you've got the hoop off of your neck, we are going to catch it out to our side with our thumb pointed up, okay? This is a very important grip. From here, I want you to lower the hoop to the ground, so it's by your legs, and then step in with your right foot first and follow with your left. Okay? So you are neck hooping, push the hoop off and catch. Bring the hoop down to your legs, step in with your right, then with your left, and then bend down and ghost the hoop all the way up to the top. Okay, one last time. Neck hooping, get the hoop off and catch it. Push the hoop down, jump in with your right, follow with your left, and then ghost all the way up to the top. How you achieve this ghosting motion is that once both legs are in the hoop, you should be gripping your hoop to the side, or at the side rather. From here, I want you to isolate this bottom portion of the hoop down to your knees so that you are at 6 o'clock now. And then isolate this side of the hoop, the left side, all the way back up to 12 as you stand up. And that's how you get that isolation movement. Okay, so you are bending down to your knees and then raising up. So the hoop should be in front of your face. Your fingers are wrapped towards your face. And that's how you isolate up. So let's go over this trick two times together, and then we are going to jump right into the recording of where I left off for the next trick. 3, 2, 1. Full, escalator, catch, put it on your shoulder, lean, hoop, neck movement, catch, leg, up to your face. Last time, fold, catch, push the hoop out and onto your shoulder, lean and push, catch, right, left, isolate up. Now, those are the two tricks that are missing in the recording. The rest is 100% from the class. I know I didn't have people to stop and ask questions that you might have had about any of these tricks because there were no people to ask me questions just now. So if you have any questions about what I just taught, please feel free to reach out to me and ask me any questions you may have. I teach hoops full time now, so I should be available whenever you are. All right, now let's get right into the rest of the tricks. Okay, so we are gonna move on to this next trick. It's a behind the back fold. And you guys have been like blowing up my story about this trick that I started doing recently. Let me grab my hoop. This is what it looks like. Okay, so it's actually a lot easier than it looks. Essentially, how you can get into this trick is you want to end in any way that has your hands positioned like this behind your back. So you can get into that position by doing an escalator to catch and then moving it up to your right. I'll show you again. So I'm doing an escalator up, and then I'm catching the hoop at the center of my back. Okay, and then I'm using this hand, and I'm pushing to my right, so the hoop falls to my right. It's kind of like this motion that we learned in our last trick earlier, just previous to this one. Okay, so it's escalator, catch, move our hand out to the right. From here, you're going to grip the hoop with your bottom hand, your thumb is pointed to the side like you're hitchhiking. And you're going to take this center hand and turn your thumb so it's facing the same direction as this one. So it's to my right. So again, I caught my hoop with my thumb up, but now I'm going to re-grip and shift my thumb
So it's to the right.
Right? I guess actually it's pointing down now that I'm looking at it in the camera. So one last time, because I know that can be tricky. Catch it, thumb is up, regrip, thumb is down. Okay? Now, I find it best to learn this trick by taking both of my hands and putting the hoop in between these two fingers. Okay? So I'm taking my two fingers here. So now I have this interesting grip on my hoop with both fingers. Okay, so again, this is how it looks like. Up, regrip, regrip, put my fingers in. The fork grip, yes, I love that term. I'm gonna start using that, the fork grip. Okay, so from here, once everybody's here, what we're gonna do is we're going to take this hand. I'm going to be calling this my top hand because it's on top. I'm going to be calling this hand my behind the back hand because it's behind my back. From here, we're going to take my top hand and we are going to push our hula hoops back away from our bodies and then fold them forwards in front of our bodies. I want you to take a look at my behind the back hand real quick. Look at my grip switch. I'm pushing it back. And then when it feels like my fingers are about to break, I'm going to let go of the hoop and then re-grab it in my fork grip. The grip on my top hand has not changed at all. It's still in between my fingers.
Can you teach how to catch after escalator behind the back?
Yeah. Okay, so real quickly, going back to this, it's an upward escalator, right? So I step in, and as the hoop is coming up, it should hit the center of your back. So have your hand open in the center of your back. And after I've caught it at the center of my back, the momentum from my escalator is going to continue to swing my hoop around to my right side. Okay? Catch, swing to my right. If you can't quite get into the escalator catch, for now, just focus on holding the hoop like this so we can learn the hold. Okay, so going back to what I was saying, we're in fork grip. We're pushing our hula hoops back away from our bodies and towards the front. When my behind the back hand feels like my fingers can't go anymore, I'm letting go of the hula hoop completely and then re-catching in fork grip. Okay? From here, I'm going to keep a super, super loose grip on my hula hoop with both hands, almost like I'm ghosting. And I'm going to cross my hands behind my back, okay? And then I'm going to take my hand that's on the bottom. I don't know if you guys can see it. I'm going to shoot it out to my left. So now we're in the same position as we started, but this time we are on our left. Again, I'm going to continue to go super slow because this is a little tricky. We are going to catch, bring it out to our right, regrip. So we are in fork grip. Gonna push our hula hoops back and then towards our face and then regrip with our behind the back hand. From here, we are going to just basically balance the hoop between our fingers and push it so our hands are crossed behind our backs. Then the hand that's on the bottom, you can see me wiggling my thumb here, I'm going to shoot it out so it's to my left. And then from here, I'm going to take my hula hoop, fold it back behind me. So it's like this, okay? The hoop is in front of my shoulder blade. And then using a super light grip, I'm going to cross my arms behind me. And then to get to my right hand side, I'm taking my hand that's on the bottom and shooting it out to my right.
How are we feeling about that? Do you guys need me to keep on doing it? Yo, I feel like a half wet noodle in this fork grip. Is that a good thing though? I feel like that would be a good thing. Okay, yeah, does anybody have any questions? What I like to do in my class is I like to tell people to hold up numbers of how comfortable they are with a trick. One being, what the heck am I doing with a hula hoop? And five being, I could teach this to a friend. So hold up a number of where you're at with this behind the back fold so I can gauge. We got a four.
I think I need you to go over the, like, how did we get to crossing the hands behind the back?
Yeah, I can do that. Full screen. Oh, wait, didn't want to do that. Speaker view. Okay, so we are here, right? Fork grip. My fingers on the bottom right here, they feel like they can't go farther anymore, so I'm re-gripping. So it feels comfortable. And from here, I'm going to basically just balance the hula hoop in my fingers, and I'm just going to let it fall behind my back and bend my arm. So this arm that's out to the side, I'm just going to take it in and bend it. Okay, and I'm gonna let the hula hoop slide through my fork grip. So very loose grip here, I'm just bending my hoop behind my back. Okay. And then the hand that's on bottom, same thing, I'm just extending it out to my side. I didn't do anything with my bent hand. I just left it bent, my top hand, and I just extended my bottom hand out to my left. Does that make sense, Molly?
Ooh, my phone's falling. Okay, yeah, that makes a little bit more sense now. I'm starting to get it.
Okay, cool. And I didn't tell you guys this at the beginning, but I actually recorded all of these tricks in slow-mo. And I'm going to give you the link to that YouTube resource after the class is over. So if this is like confusing you, you can watch me do it 8 million times in slow-mo. So let's just go ahead and feel out this fold. Let's just take like a minute or two to do this. I love this one. It's such a creative fold. Yeah, I know. I love it too. I feel like it's just super unexpected. And whenever I posted it on my story, you guys were like, how are you doing that? So yeah, I don't know. I think it's very fun to go into your flow. Anyway, so let's just go ahead and practice this behind the back fold on our own time a couple times. I'm going to show you guys a couple more times from the front. So if you're confused, you can watch me. And then I'm going to show you from the back a couple times too. So I'm going to get into it from my escalator, catching it, bringing it out to the side. Fork grip. I'm going to take the hoop and bend it down towards the ground and then up towards my face. Then I'm going to shift the hoop to my left. Then the same thing, I'm going to fold the hoop down to the ground and then up towards my face. I notice that sometimes when I do this trick, I'm a girl that has slightly larger hips. I have to move my hips out of the way in order to get the hula hoop to go where it's supposed to go. So if I didn't move my hips out of the way, bam, it's like hitting my butt, right? So sometimes you need to groove with it and make space for your hula hoop. I find that even when I use a smaller hula hoop, it's still harder for me to get the hoop to completely clear over my back end. So from the back again, escalator catch, fork grip, thumbs are facing down, fold the hoop down to the ground and then up towards the face. From here, I'm letting the hoop slide down to the back. So I'm bringing this right arm that's straight and I'm just bending it behind my back. From here, I'm using my bottom hand to shoot the hoop out to my left. Then I take the top of the hoop and bend it down to the ground, clearing space for the hula hoop. And then I let the hoop fall down as I bend my straight arm in. The key is to really have a very, very loose grip on the hula hoop as you're doing this trick so that it can ghost when it needs to and just slide in and out. If anybody has any final questions, I will answer them. If not, I'm going to move along to the next trick. Folds me.
I have.
Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
No, you could go first. It's okay.
Oh, I was just reading Sydney. She said, this fold makes me feel real sassy. And I totally relate to that.
So I have a question because when you were like ending after you did the fold and then like, you know, behind and stuff. And then when you landed like this way, I guess, your fingers were like almost like an archery type of like that.
Yeah.
And mine were ending differently. So I didn't know if I was doing it wrong or if like it doesn't matter or
okay. Yeah, no. Honestly, if you can still do the trick, it really doesn't matter how your fingers are. My fingers probably ended like that because that's just like what felt most comfortable to me. So let me see. So I'm here. Bop, bop, bop. So are you saying like right here, I just kind of gripped it with one?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So that comes from this like little hook grip. But the fork grip, so mine was just upside down. So
okay, it just looked like it looked better that way. So I was like,
yeah,
how do I get all elegant like that?
I think it was upside down because originally it was facing the right way, and then because I flipped it, then it's like it probably looked more upside down or whatever.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Okay, any last questions? Remove spotlight. Going once, going twice. Okay, we are moving into the next trick, which is a lot easier actually. So this will give us a nice break. If you have any water with you, let's go ahead and take a quick water break. I feel like I've been talking forever, so I need to moisten my throat. That sounds really weird, but whatever. We'll go with it. Okay. So the next trick is a backpack to smear to wedgie switch. This is the fourth trick I'm teaching. We only have three left, so we're gonna power through it. This is what it looks like. Okay, so it's super sassy. I really encourage you to play this trick up as much as you can because that's what it's meant for. We are going to start off with the hoop in our right hand, and we are going to go into a one-handed over the head smear. Okay, now if you guys don't know how to do a smear, I'm going to teach you how to do it real quick. So what I'm doing is I'm starting my hoop with my right hand. From here, I'm going to level it out so it's parallel with the floor and the ceiling above me. From here, I'm going to shoot my hoop out to my left side. And then once it gets to my left side, I'm going to put it into wall plane, which just basically means the hoop is vertical. And I'm going to pretend that this bottom half of the hoop is a magnet. And I'm also going to pretend that my lower back is also a magnet. So what do two magnets that are oppositely charged do? They stick together, okay? So all together, I flip it so it's in floor plane, move it across, flip it again, thumb facing down, so it's in wall plane, and then scoop the hoop behind me so my magnets can connect to each other. And then now my arm should be above my head. The idea to get a smear going is you want to have a good amount of momentum so that when you scoop the hoop to your back, you're going to completely let go of the hula hoop and it is going to smear, okay? So one last time before we go on. It looks like you guys have been hooping for a long time from what I could see in the chat, so I'm not gonna spend too much time on this. If you have any more questions about this trick after the workshop, go ahead and hit me up. Starting out to our right, flip our hoop so it's parallel with the floor and ceiling, scoop to our left, connect it to our back, let go, and then catch, okay? So now that we know how to do a smear, I'm going to teach you how to go into a smear to backpack. Essentially, I'm gonna get down real quick. Essentially what you're doing is when the hoop comes around to the front of your face, on your left-hand side, there should be a gap. You are going to push your free arm through and then follow it with your right arm. Again, smearing when the hoop comes to your front, For me, I'm personally looking for blue tubing. Whenever I see blue tubing, that's when I know to stick my hand through. So you might be having a pink hula hoop, look for pink tubing, okay? So it's behind your back, bam, I see the blue tubing, which means I'm going to stick my right arm through and then follow it with my left. One more time, smear, see your hula hoop, stick your arm down to the right, and then follow it with my left. Any questions on how to get it into backpack before I move on? I'm going to go to gallery view real quick. Okay, I'm gonna count down from three, and when I get to one, or after I'm done counting down, can I see you guys all do it for me? 3, 2, 1. Good job, Cindy. Good job, Lydia. Good job, Willow. Good job, Gabriella. 50 Zoom names later, I'm just calling out everybody I see on screen. Okay, awesome. We're gonna go on to the next part of the trick unless anybody has a question. Unmute yourself now. So, from backpack, we are going to go into this ghosting behind the back, okay? So what you do is you take your left hand, right? Wiggle, wiggle. You're going to grab the bottom of your hula hoop. This is like 7 o'clock on my hula hoop, as if it were a clock. Note how my fingers are curled away from my body. And I'm going to take my right hand, wiggle, wiggle, move it into my hula hoop. So right now I'm just holding the hula hoop behind my back. From here, I'm going to turn in over my right shoulder. And as I do that, I'm going to isolate this portion of my hula hoop all the way up to the top, like this. Okay, again, I'm in backpack. I grab the bottom of my hula hoop, making sure my fingers are curled away from my face, isolating this top portion or this side portion of the hula hoop all the way up to the top. Bam, okay? From here, we're going to go into a fun little wedgie switch. I'm holding the hoop in my left hand. I'm going to bring it down to the ground. From the back, down to the ground, taking my left foot, I'm going to step on my hula hoop. Don't worry, you won't break it. Polypros are surprisingly a lot more bendy than you think, okay? Stepping on your hula hoop. You're going to take your right leg, bring it up and over the hoop, and then through the back, okay? So again, let's go over that all together from here, after we just did our isolation. We are going to bring the hoop down, and you can bring the hoop down in any way you want. You can like make it like you can go to the music, like you can wiggle it down. Just like really, like I said, feel free to express this movement however you want. I'm gonna let somebody in real quick. Okay. So you brought the hula hoop down to the ground. Then you're going to take your left leg, step on the hula hoop. Right leg goes up and back. Somebody's on mute. Okay, there we go. From here, we are going to strike two poses. So give me a second. I'm gonna turn my heater off because it's getting a little loud. Okay, so bam, we're right here. From here, we're going to strike two poses, but first I'm going to show you how to flick the hula hoop up. You should have a left leg on top of the hula hoop. This left leg is going to peel back just ever so slightly and then kick up. So what happened? The hoop flew up to your back, right? That's what we wanted to do. Bam. When it flies up to your back, you're going to take your left hand and shoot it down and out to the side so you can catch it when it's up here. Okay? So let's go ahead and practice that a couple times. Get the hoop down to the ground any way you want it.
step with your left leg, up and back with your right leg. Take your left foot, peel the hoop back just a little bit, flip it up and catch. You want to make sure that you are really catching the hula hoop in a down and back motion, because if you just shoot your arm out to the side, it's not gonna work. It really has to be like a, almost as if you're a bird and you're like unfolding your wings to fly, for lack of a better term. Okay, no questions so far, awesome. Bam. Now I'm gonna talk about the poses that you can add to this. Gotta add somebody in real quick, admit all. Okay, they're admitted. So once you bring the hula hoop down to the ground, I like to step on, and then as I push my leg up and over, I like to strike a pose. It could be any pose you want, whatever you're feeling in that moment, anything just to like give this move some extra sass. So what I like to do is strike with my hands out to my side. The next pose you do can be anything you want, but it has to end with your right hand out to the side so that you can catch the hula hoop. So basically what I'm saying is that your left hand can do whatever you want, but your right hand has to be out into the side so it can catch in this wedgie lock position. So let's go ahead and play with a different couple or different types of poses. You guys can explore your own movement of how you want to move your arms. Let's go ahead and do it. So bam, you just drop the hoop down, step on it, step up and over. Pose how you want, pose how you want. Again, let's try to do a different pose, okay? Bam, drop the hoop down, step on, step up and over. Pose how you want, pose how you want. Okay, last time, try to think up of one more pose you can do. Drop the hoop down, step on, up and over. Pose how you want, then pose how you want.
Okay, thank you so much. I got a run. Okay, thank you for coming, Ren. Like I said, we're going to be uploading the recording very shortly after the class. So stay tuned for that. Okay, does anybody have any more questions before we practice this trick together? Oh, I didn't even tell you guys how to get out of the trick. That should probably be helpful. So we end the trick like this. There are a few ways that you can get out of this wedgie lock position. The easiest one would be to take your left hand and fold it into your body so the hoop goes into wedgie. Okay? So I'm not doing anything else but taking my left hand and bringing it in. Another way that you could end this trick or get out of this locked position is to take your right hand, wiggle, 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 grip the side of your hula hoop. My grip is like this, to where my thumb is pointed down. I'm gonna take your left hand, wiggle, 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 bring it in as well, and then slide the hula hoop down your right leg and step out. So again, right hand grabs the front, left hand peels in, then I slide it down my right leg and step out. The third way that you can get out of this little lock here, and my personal favorite way, is I like to take my right hand, grab that same spot, okay? And I like to take my left hand, curl it in, and take my right leg and bring it towards my chest. So the hoop swings back over my feet. So this is what it looks like. Right hand grips, left hand comes in, and then I step up, crunch in, and then the hoop is centered around my body. I've never done the second transition, neato. Oh yeah, I just thought of the second transition like very recently. Okay, does anybody have any questions about any of this? If not, we're going to try this trick together a couple of times. Wait, that's easier than I thought. Yes. That's amazing. Yeah, this one is like pretty easy, but it's also super fun. Can I see the second transition again? Yes.
So, second transition. You're here. Take your right hand, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Grab the hula hoop right by your groin area. Take your left hand, bring it into your chest. So you're just holding up the hula hoop with your one hand. And then you're going to take this hand and let it slide down your leg and then step out of the hula hoop. So from the front, it looks like this. And this is also a really good transition because you can go into like a chest roll, you can go into a coin flip, like literally whatever you want when your hand is like, ends like this. How do you stop the hoop on your shoulder during the pose so sharply? Mine is kind of wobbly, I'm not locking it properly. During the, okay. So that might have to do something with hoop size. Maybe you're using a hula hoop that's too small. Let me see. It also comes with practice too. So I do wedgie locks like 8 million trillion times in my flow. But what you can do if you want to just practice getting into the lock position is just practice doing a wedgie. Okay, so I'm wedgieing up to my right. My right leg's inside of the hoop. My left leg's outside of the hoop. And then when the hoop comes up, I'm pushing my hand down and then up. It's very much of a downward sweeping motion up to the sky. So if you're having problems like getting into it with this lock thing that we're doing, go ahead and just take a step back and practice just the basic wedgie lock. Okay? Any other questions? Going once. Going.
Can I just say something?
Yes.
I like this trick because I feel like I lack that poise, like elegancy, and you always do everything so good, and I feel like this trick gives me like maybe a little bit more like confidence, I guess you'd say, to like,
yeah, just, like, yeah, it's like more flow, you know what I mean, like it gives you the ability to dance within your flow, you know what I mean,
and just, yeah, instead of being like, I feel like sometimes I'm very like closed and like not like fully like wanting to be like vulnerable with my hoop, I guess, and I feel like it makes me want to like, you know, extra.
That's what hooping is for. I'm so glad it makes you feel that way.
Thank you.
Okay, so if we have no more questions, I'm going to go into, let's see, what do we got next? Okay, the next trick. So let me demonstrate how it looks like. It is a half back roll to behind the back coin flip. It's a little bit more advanced, but I do offer a couple of modifications for this trick. So this is how it looks like. Okay, I don't know if you guys can see that with the blue hoop. It didn't look right on my screen. So let me try it with the green one. Okay, so. I like to teach this trick with a behind the back half chest roll.
That's fucking cool.
Oh, somebody unmuted. Thank you, but I'm going to mute you. I still love you, but I'm trying to make sure everyone's muted. Okay, perfect. So how you do that is we're going in from an anti-spin, right? If you don't know how to do an anti-spin, I want you to move this up a little bit because we're more up here now. Bring our hoop, start with your hand at 6 o'clock. Bring our hoop up. So you're regripping at 6 o'clock. So I just went down, let it go, then come up. From here, I'm going to let go of the hoop as it swings behind my back. And then I'm going to push it into my half chest roll. So behind, start at 6 o'clock, push up 6 o'clock, come down. Then I'm going to stick my thumb and back towards behind me. So it rolls to where my grip is like this. And I'm going to roll it halfway down my shoulder. So let's go ahead and practice just this a couple of times. And then I'm gonna show you what you can do if you're really not feeling this behind the back movement, you can still do this trick. Grip at six, push it up, push it down, stick our thumb in. So now your hoop should be like this, right? From here, we are going to take our palms and touch the back of our necks. So your hoop can roll down in a half chest roll. I feel the closer you bring your palm to your neck is what's really gonna help the hoop roll where it needs to go. So again, 6 o'clock, push it up, push it down, stick our thumb in, prep our hand, then touch our hoops to our neck. Last time before I show you the modification. 6 o'clock, push it up, push it down, slap our necks, okay? If that is feeling way too advanced for you, good news, you can still do this trick. What you can instead do is just your regular back roll. You want to make sure that when you're catching your back roll with your receiving hand, your thumb is pointed upward, okay? So, back roll, catch with your thumb facing up. A tip to get a really nice smooth back roll if you're new to this trick is literally, this is gonna look so ridiculous, bend down at like 90 degrees. Okay, I didn't do that right, but that's how you do it, okay? You wanna just bend down and then catch. Once you get more advanced with back rolls, you'll be able to do them standing straight up. But because your accuracy isn't quite there yet, you want to make sure you're creating a nice, big, flat back for that hoop to roll across. Okay? Let's go ahead and practice your back roll of choice 3 times before we move on. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. Back roll. Again, back roll. Last time, back roll. Perfect. So we ended this trick with our thumb pointed up. From here, we are going to go into a behind the back coin flip. This is something that I've been doing a lot lately and I love it for lack of a better explanation. So what you're essentially doing is you're taking your hand and you're moving it from your left side to your right side and your thumb is pointed down. I can't see if you guys can see that. Yeah, thumb is pointed down, right? You want to make sure that you're bringing the hoop as far to your right as you possibly can. This is where shoulder flexibility really comes in handy because you want to give the hoop enough space to coin flip. How you get that coin flip motion is taking your thumb, notice how it's pointed down, you are going to flip it up because that's the only direction your thumb can go, okay? It can't go like down back that way. That would just like literally break your wrist. So it's very intuitive to know that your thumb should naturally just want to flip up. You notice that I am leaning towards my left because like I said, I'm a hippie girl. I gotta make space for my hoop to clear. So if you find that your hoop is hitting your body, maybe you need to lean more towards your left and stick your arm out more towards the right. So let's not even worry about catching our hula hoops. We're just gonna try this behind the back coin flip a couple of times. Okay, make sure you're starting with your thumb pointed down and then flip it up. Okay, so my thumb is literally going down and then pushing up. Last time, down, push it up. Okay, so now we're going to talk about how to catch this dang hula hoop now that it's coin flipping in the air. What I found with this trick is that you get, what you essentially want is the hoop to fly up into the air
high enough so that you can first register where the heck it is, and then second, catch it with your hand. Looks like I got a question. Coin flips are the bane of my existence. Yeah, me too, honestly. They were at first. I like never practiced them, but the more you practice, the better you get, I promise. And plus, you know, we'll get through it together. So anyway, like I was saying, you really want to try to give the hula hoop enough momentum in the air so that you can register where the heck it is and how the heck you're gonna catch it. So what I want you to do is practice doing that coin flip from a swing, because you're trying to gather up that momentum. And how you do that is by giving it a swing. Okay? So make sure you are starting your swing with your thumb facing up until it comes down and your hand comes down and then your thumb is facing down, okay? And I really want you in your mind to just try to get the hula hoop as high up in the sky as you can. Okay, 1, 2, 3, swing. I start my coin flip once I know that the hoop has completely cleared my hips. Okay, I'm gonna see how you guys look with this real quick. Going into gallery view. I'm gonna count down from 3. When I get to 1, go ahead and do it. 3, 2, 1, go. Wow, that looks so good. Oh my gosh, I'm like totally over explaining things. You guys are doing it so well. Yeah, and a couple of you already know how to catch it, which is awesome. Nora, I really like your PJs. I'm just now seeing them. And your Santa hat, it's so cute. Okay, yeah, so going back, like I said, you'll notice that the higher you get the hula hoop up to your right, the easier you'll be able to catch it. So if your hula hoop is like coin flipping down there, like who the heck is gonna catch that, right? So make sure you're getting it nice and high. And then what I do to catch it, I just literally stick my arm straight out in through the circle, and then it'll be resting on my bicep. And then I will re-grip it into chicken grip. And then you can fold out and go into anything you want. So again, get my hand in, re-grip into chicken grip, and then fold it out. Okay, we're gonna practice the entire trick from the back roll together. Like I said, do any back roll you want. We're gonna work through it 3 times, and then we're gonna move on if anybody doesn't have any questions. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Again, 3, 2, 1, go. Last time, 3, 2, 1, go. All right. Does anybody have any final questions before we move on?
I have a question.
Yes.
I feel like it's always me.
Oh, you're good.
How you said, like, when you do it like right here, like nobody's gonna catch that. I don't know how to get it higher. Like I'm trying to like do it higher, but I feel like it's just not happening.
So what I recommend that you can do, let me go back to me, is before you practice this trick, you can try some like shoulder stretches, like a couple of these, you know, just really like loosening up your shoulders. Because in order to get it to go as high as you need, you're really going to have to bend that arm as far to up and to the right as you can. And you'll notice that when I'm also doing it, I'm like flicking my wrist up to the air as well.
Okay.
Yeah, so if you're, I feel like, you notice how like my hand is like super low, it's like by my butt, and that's why my hoop didn't get above my hips. When I'm doing the trick, how I do it correctly is that, look at my hand. It's all the way up by my shoulder blade, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you just wanna try to get that arm up as high as it can go, because that means your hoop will go up as high as it can go as well.
Okay, yeah, I think having it like up here, it makes a difference. I can't catch it yet, but I threw it higher.
I at least see you getting some rotations in on that coin flip, which is good.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Any other questions before we move on? Oh, somebody said to get the motion is hard to throw with a heavier hoop. Yeah, that's also a good point. I don't know what size hoops you guys are using, but this one is a 28-inch 5/8, and I can do this trick. If you're using maybe like a 3/4-inch hoop or like a hoop that's a heavier tubing or something, like a dance hoop, like that's obviously gonna be super hard if you don't have the wrist strength for it. So yeah, don't be afraid to play around with smaller hoops. Thanks, Allison, that was a really good suggestion.
Yeah, maybe that's why I can't do it, because mine's an 11/16, so like it's thin, but it's heavy. But I just ordered, this is a 28, but I just ordered a 27 that's 5/8. So maybe I'll be able to do it better once that comes in.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, because when I had an 11/16 tubing hoop, I really liked it as a beginner because I felt like the weight was just heavy enough to like stabilize my awkward movements. But as I wanted to get into like more techie tricks, I felt like it was too heavy. So
yeah, that's why I ordered this one, because I have a 30-inch 5/8, but it was big, but it was really light. So I was like, well, it's supposed to be like Goldilocks tubing, right? Mm-hmm. But then a lot of tricks, I find that it's actually heavy and it hurts sometimes. So
yeah, definitely. Yeah. Especially with breaks, I would assume. So
yeah, so thank you. And thank you to whoever said that about the light hoop.
Allison coming in clutch. Okay, so if we have no more questions, I'm gonna move on to the second to last trick. We only got two more before we go ahead and draw the winner of the Mood Hoops giveaway here. This is how the trick looks like. Woohoo! I'm actually going to use my green hoop to teach this trick because I feel like it shows up way better. So this trick is going to start off with a behind the back juggle toss. So what I'm doing is I'm gripping the hoop in my dominant hand, my right hand, thumb pointed up. From here, I'm going to take my non-dominant hand and place it towards the center of my back. And using my wrist with the hand that's holding my hoop, I'm going to flick it up and then catch it like this. Okay. You want to make sure you are catching the bottom of the hoop instead of the top of the hoop, which would look like this. I don't even know if I can do it. Okay, you don't want that. You want to catch it like this. If you want to be a little bit more advanced about it, you can take the hoop and roll it down your arm and catch it like this. This was a move that I learned from Miss Mojangles. So she totally like 100% inspired this little combo that I made up. So after you've caught your hula hoop in however way you want behind your back, we are going to shift our hand up and to the left and rest the side of the hula hoop on this little space in our neck. Okay, and we're gonna let it fall. So that's a little bit awkward, so let's go ahead and practice that a couple times. Behind the back, catch, shift our hula hoop up into the left, and rest it in that little nestling position right here. One last time, catch the hoop, whoop. Flip our wrist inward into the left, and then rest it right here in this little nuzzle. From here, we are going to go into a two-handed smear. So what I'm doing is I'm taking both of my hands, tucking them into my chest, inside of the hula hoop, and I'm going to take my hands and wrap them around to the front into a smear. So again, I'm gonna show you from the front. Take my hands, bring them into the hoop. I'm going to, as I fold my body forward, I'm going to grip the bottom of the hoop and then shift my weight up and around. So your body is doing a little circle and your hands are just re-gripping the hoop. Again, from the back, catch, rest, switch swoop it in. Roll, catch, rest, swoop it in. Okay?
So you should end with your fingers pointed away from your face and the hoop is at your forehead. From here, we are going to hinge the hoop outward. Okay, so we're here and then we're here. Our thumbs should be pointed towards each other. From here, we are going to bring this part of the hula hoop back and towards our body. So it's a little folding motion here. And then we're going to ghost the top. So again, fold, toss and catch, nestle it in, smear it to our right, fold it out, thumbs are facing each other, bring this part into our body, and then ghost. Okay? From here, this is the advanced version. I'm going to teach the advanced version, and then you can decide if you would like to go into the modified version once I teach that. You are going to take the bottom of the hula hoop, flip it up, and then catch it in that little spot between your thigh and your calf, right? So a couple tips for that. As I'm tossing, woo, oh my gosh, that was almost really bad. I almost knocked over my cup of water. Anyway, as you're doing that, I find it's best to let the hula hoop fall and then stick my leg in. So as you can see, I'm kind of turning my torso towards my left and then sticking my catching foot back and towards my right. Okay. If this is a trick that you are finding that you are struggling with, you can work up to it by practicing this little drill.
Holding your hoop out to your right, folding it inward, make sure your thumb is facing up, and then flipping the hoop over your shoulder to catch it in the same position.
I started off with these little coin flip leg catches by just doing this. And eventually I found that if I did like a crap ton of these, I started to get a feel of when to put my leg up. I started to develop the timing for it. So if you're not quite there yet from this, just go ahead and practice an arm fold into wedgie catch. Okay. If you can do that, the whole thing, that's the trick. If you can't do that, I'm going to show you how to modify it. So here's what the modified version looks like of this trick. I don't think you guys could quite see that, so let me grab my writer loop real quick. Again, the modified version. Okay. So if you'd like to learn the modified version, we're going to go in from here, where we let the hoop nestle right on our neck and our collarbone. From here, we're going to take our hands, put them into the hula hoop, right? I'm leaning to my left and I'm gonna regrip the hula hoop. From here, we are going to hinge the hoop out and down as we lift our leg. Once we have our leg inside of the hula hoop, we are going to let go and we will be in a wedgie. Okay? So here's what it looks like all together. Bam, here. Then I'm going to regrip the hula hoop and I'm immediately going to slap it diagonally down into my opposite side leg as I'm lifting the leg so I can be in my wedgie. One last time from the back, the modified version. Juggle, toss, catch, rest it in our neck. Grab the hula hoop, toss it down. Does anybody have, oh wait, the timing helped me a lot with catching it, but not going for it for it till it starts to fall. I'm not sure what you mean by that, Molly. If you want to unmute yourself, I could probably answer that question better. Yeah. Go ahead.
Oh, so I don't know like what you were doing, but it really helped a lot. I don't know if I just interpreted it differently, but like when you do the whole like coin flip,
yeah.
And I usually like try to like immediately catch it, but if I wait until that moment where it starts to like fall and then, that's like really helped.
Yes, yes. It's all about letting it fall. You know, you really want the hula hoop to come to you for a lot of these tricks, guys. So yeah, you know, we're gonna get there eventually. These moves are pretty techie. Okay, so does anybody have any questions? If not, we're gonna do this trick 2 times together and then we're gonna move on to the final trick of the day. Going once, going twice. I see Nora giving me a thumbs up. Okay, we are gonna move on then. Or sorry, we're gonna do this trick 2 times and then we're gonna move on.
3, 2, 1, go. Juggle, toss, catch, smear it around. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys from the front again. 3, 2, 1, juggle, toss, catch. Ghost it out. Okay, last time. 3, 2, 1. All right. We are moving into our final trick of the day, and it's super easy. So we're gonna end things off on an easy note. This is what it looks like. It's an anti-spin to cat-eye combo. That ends in a wedgie lock. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna take your hoop in your dominant hand. You're going to grip kind of the inner side of the hula hoop because we are going to go into an anti-spin. My anti-spin is moving counterclockwise. So quick lesson on anti-spins, if you're not really sure how the heck to do that yet, is if you want it to move counterclockwise, wait, nope, that would be clockwise, my bad. You would want to start off with the hoop spinning counterclockwise, okay? So it's out in front of you, spinning counterclockwise. From here, you're going to move your hand up in a diagonal to the left, making sure you keep your hand nice and flat, parallel with the floor and the ceiling. It's just rotating on my knuckles. Then from here, you're going to move your hand in a diagonal up to 12 o'clock. And then again, move it down at a diagonal to 9. And then move it down in a diagonal to 6. So if you're just learning anti-spins, go ahead and just sit with a couple rotations on each point. So maybe you'll do 3 rotations, then move, 3 rotations, then up, 3 rotations, then down, and then back to the center. And then once you get more comfortable with it, you can move in between rotations. Okay? Moving on, after you've done a full anti-spin, you're going to stop here at 9 o'clock. My thumb is pointed up, I'm gripping the outside of the hoop. From here, I'm going to let go of the hoop and let it roll across my hand as I move my hand from 9 o'clock all the way to 3. Now you'll notice that you should be gripping the hoop with your thumb facing down. So again, starting at 6, 6, 9, 12, 3, grip the hoop, let it roll back over your hand, grip the hoop at 9. Again, 6, 9, 12, 3, let go of the hoop and let it roll. And honestly, you can do as many cat eyes as your little heart desires. I'm just probably gonna do 2. But you want to make sure you end with your hand on the hoop, based with your thumb pointing down, and the hoop at 9 o'clock. From here, we are going to go into our wedgie lock. So what you want to do is when you let go of the hoop and it starts coming back towards your body, you are going to take your arm and stick it through the hoop your left leg, stick it also through the hoop. Okay, so right now you should only have your left leg, your left arm, and your right leg through the hoop. From here, you are going to take the hand that is gripping the hoop, okay, and you are going to push it up and over your head and let it rest right here in front of your shoulder, making sure that your right hand is outside of the hula hoop still, okay? So I push my opposite arm and leg through the hoop, then push it over my shoulder. Make sure you pop your right arm out so that the wedgie, so that the hoop can stay locked in this wedgie lock position. If you find that you are stepping through the hula hoop, that's cool, but that's not how to do the trick. If you find that you're stepping through the hula hoop, that means that you did not lock your right hand out, okay? So just the opposite side legs, then push the hoop up and over your shoulder, and bam. Okay, in order to get into this lock position, I really want you to have some body awareness and notice that you only have two limbs inside of your hula hoop, and they're the opposite side limbs, right? And then I want you to notice that you have two limbs outside of the hula hoop, and they're the opposite side arm and leg. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into the lock position. Bam. From here, you are going to turn over your right shoulder back to the front. You can really play up this move by doing something with your arms. I like to raise them from the bottom to the top. You could also just keep them out to the side and flex your hands. You could have one hand out to the side and the other hand circling around your head. Just really feel what your body wants to do in this moment and move your arms accordingly. After you've done your spin, you're going to take your right hand and peel it out from the hula hoop so you are in wedgie. Okay? To make it more advanced, after you peel your arm outside of the hula hoop, you can immediately hit the hula hoop back. So again, peel it out, then hit it back. Peel it out, hit it back. Okay? One more time from the front. Okay. And then you are in wedgie and you can flick it up and go into whatever your little heart desires. Let's go ahead and do this trick full out together. I'm gonna count down from three. Three, two, one. Anti-spin, cat eye, pull it into the lock, twirl around, exit by peeling your arm back into your wedgie. Again, anti-spin, when you reach 9 o'clock, pull it into a cat eye, push your body through, wedgie. Okay, anybody have any questions or need to watch me do it again? How are you guys feeling about that?
I'm curious about the little like push that you did after we, like after we're in that position or whatever, and then you hit it.
I don't know who's talking real quick. Can you like just wave your hoop at the screen so I can find you? Okay, I see you now.
We go like that. It's whenever we're in this spot and then like we go down like that, and but you hit it.
Mm-hmm.
Right there, can you go over that?
Yeah, let me go over that again. So this one I actually learned this summer from a hooper on Instagram. His name is Guapo13 Brandon, and he calls this the daddy slap, which I think is like an amazing name for it. But anyway, so what I'm doing is I'm taking my right hand and I'm peeling it back. Show you from the back because my camera's not here, right? And then immediately, once my fingertips are no longer touching the hoop, it's going to fly straight down. So that means we gotta move a little quickly. So what I'm doing is I'm taking my left hand and I'm going to slap it on the top, and my right hand is going to slap it on the bottom. Okay, so I'm just gonna catch it so you can see where the contact points are. So I'm here, 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 bam. I'm catching it like this, and then I'm slapping it backwards. Okay, so again, here, slap it back. Does that make more sense?
Yes, I'll probably just have to practice it.
Yeah, it's pretty quick, and it looks like you have a small hoop too. I'm not sure how big it is, but maybe if you try this trick with a bigger hoop, it'll like slow down the little slapping motion for you. Okay, does anybody have any more questions before we move on to the final part of the workshop? The drawing giveaway, $150 store credit to Mood Hoops. Going once, going twice. Okay, I'm going to, let's see. Okay, as for the rest of us, I always like to end my classes with a little flow jam. Just a little flow jam. Just so you guys can practice what I taught today, or so you can just feel yourself and have fun flowing with the class. So I'm gonna go ahead and share my audio, and we are going to flow to one song real quick. All right, if you have an LED hoop, now would be the perfect time to grab it and party. Okay, here we go. Okay, that's all I have for class for you guys today. I wanted to let you know that the recording, this is always so hard talking after losing my breath from doing all that dancing. The recording will be uploaded later today. Go ahead and just follow my Instagram so you can be notified when the recording is uploaded. I already have all of the slow-mos for these tricks uploaded to my YouTube channel. So if you feel like practicing more immediately after this class is over with, here is the link to that. So you can watch slow-mos of all the tricks.